Alice Walker, Tennessee Williams, Paul McCartney, Jimmy Carter, Steve Jobs, Bob Hope, The Rolling Stones, Elton John, and Bill Moyers are but a few notable luminaries New Orleans photographer Christopher R. Harris has captured with camera, skill, and lens. As a freelance photojournalist, Harris has completed over 2,000 assignments and placements with clients including Time, Newsweek, New York Times, Rolling Stone, Life, Esquire, People, GQ, Sunday Times of London, Time Life Books, Random House, McGraw-Hill, Gruner & Jahr, and more. Today, Harris is set to release his most revealing and profound work, a thought-provoking and intimate collection of photographs taken over a 12-year period of writer and philosopher Walker Percy, an award-winning author whose life and career have garnered amused, thoughtful readership and respect the world over. With support from Percy family members and a team that includes Percy biographer Jay Tolson, Percy scholar Linda W. Hobson, and art director Richmond Powers, Walker Percy, Daylight and Dark, Portraits by Christopher R. Harris, will be published in 2016 to honor the 100-year anniversary of Percy's birth.
You know, Walker Percy was one of the finest people I've ever met. I met him on an assignment for People magazine, and from that grew this wonderful relationship. He was almost grandfatherly to me. Yet at the same time, he was so inquisitive. He was like having a friend who was 20 years old with you at the same time. His inquisitiveness, of course, shows in his writings, but he was so incredible to me. He opened up his doors to me. Most writers don't do that. Most writers want to keep their lives a mystery. They don't want to have any kind of involvement. He always sought me out in order to make pictures for him. One of the neat things that happened with that was that when Riley came to me, wanted to do a film on Walker after he died, and so I supplied him with some of the images, which then were used in the Capitola Review for a journal article that they were writing about the film and criticism on the film. So we decided to go meet Richmond Powers, the art director, and I decided to go and meet with Walker's widow, Bunt. And she was so gracious. After she looked at our photographs, she, and by the way, she refers to me as Walker Percy's photographer, that she, as her last act, she died just recently, but one of the last literary acts that she did was to give us the rights to do this book on Walker. And it's a photo book. She knew it was going to be a photo book. She wanted other people to learn what it was to be a writer, that it was excruciating at times, it was joyous at times, it was always inquisitive, but it was what Walker Percy was about. During an extensive two-year period, both in the Garden District and at a famous hotel in the French Quarter, art director Richmond Powers and I literally printed up over 400 images out of the 1,500 negatives that we had taken a look at. And from that, through a very painstaking ordeal of trying to figure out what you want to put in, what is more emotional as opposed to being usable for the general public. So we went back and forth on this, and out of the 400 original prints that we'd edited down to, we pulled 130 photographs for inclusion in this book. So as you can tell, this is not a book about, it's not a textbook on what Walker Percy was about, but rather this is a visual textbook about what writing is about. And that's what Walker wanted in all of this. Many people were influenced by Walker Percy. I'm hoping that they will be influenced by the photographs in this book to understand who Walker Percy really was. This project has been an incredible journey for me as an artist. It's not often that you have the opportunity to photograph somebody who is just as revered as Walker Percy was. He had so much depth and perception, and his numerous essays, his novels, the way he wrote about the human condition. I mean, he was an incredible writer. But one of the things I discovered in editing this book, and I didn't really understand it when I was taking the pictures, but Walker Percy would have been an incredible film director. I now realize in many of the times that he called me in to do photographs, that he was directing what he wanted. He would place me in the positions that he wanted to be in. He would set up the locations. On his very last shoot that he asked me to come over, it was the only time he asked me to shoot color. And it was the only time I shot in his personal writing space. It's unusual to have had that opportunity. But Walker Percy allowed me to do this at the same time he was directing me to do the pictures that were to be included. And that makes this a very unusual project.
Walker Percy's solitary singularity is captured in these brilliant black and white photographs by Chris Harris. Looking into his weathered face, you grasp Percy's gentleness and his kindness. Yet you also sense the relentless malaise that haunted him throughout his 73 years, a malaise nearly dripping off the Spanish moss surrounding his South Louisiana home. You pick up Percy's tendency towards introspection and can almost hear the alienated voice of his first protagonist, Binks Bowling, off in the background. These insightful photographs give us a long, slow look at this man whose struggles brought forth masterpieces of literature for us to cherish and to learn from. Walker Percy readers will thoroughly enjoy this picture book. Mary Gaucher, musician, songwriter, author.
Walker Percy possessed a profound grace which he wore lightly, and he had eyes that knew sorrow yet could still sparkle. Chris Harris has captured all of this and more in his fine photographs, which will warm the heart of every Walker Percy fan. Walter Isaacson, author of Steve Jobs, American Sketches, and Benjamin Franklin in American Life. As one who has edited 7 volumes of Thomas Merton's journals to produce a 1-volume portrait of that author's inner journey, I marvel as I ponder these photographs of Walker Percy by Christopher Harris. Surveying and then deftly presenting the moods of his subject through a lens sometimes focused on darkness and then on light, Harris has created an intimate portrait of the artist as a multi-layered human being, moving through his life with a face expressively sculpted by tears whose eyes are easily surprised by joy. I would love to have met Walker Percy. Taking a slow pilgrimage through Harris' formal and candid portraits, these icons of Percy's roaming spirit in the flesh, my wish to encounter the artist has been mysteriously satisfied by an artist of another kind. I treasure Harris' perfect companion to Percy's books. Jonathan Montaldo, editor of The Intimate Merton, His Life from His Journals.
Christopher R. Harris's book, Walker Percy, Daylight and Dark, is indeed a sign in itself of the exhilaration and transcendence of the community formed whenever we make meaning through art, as Chris has clearly done. In partnership with his taking and developing the photographs, Walker has given his person, time, and home place to be photographed, a fine fraternal community indeed. Linda Whitney Hobson, author, Understanding Walker Percy. In his first novel, The Moviegoer, which won the National Book Award in 1962, Walker Percy expressed themes related to both the necessity and the difficulty of man's quest for meaning in life. The exploration of everydayness in which Percy sought meaning resonates with his theory of humanity that defines so much of his writing. Quote, man is more than organism, more than consumer. Man the wayfarer, man the pilgrim, man on a journey. End quote. Likewise, Walker Percy, Daylight and Dark, is a document of a similar journey and a most rare exception in photographic collections. In working through and then discarding the typical reluctance artists have in being photographed, Walker Percy invited in and allowed Harris to know the shadings, illuminations, and motions of his writing years, thereby adding another level of reader understanding, a visual perspective, to his essays, letters, and fiction. To maintain high standards, Walker Percy, Daylight and Dark, is being privately published. Your contribution will not only enable fans of Walker Percy's work to own a rare collection of photographs of the writer in life and at work, but to witness a part of his life beyond the words on a scale of detail rarely seen by readers. Your contribution toward the publication of Walker Percy, Daylight and Dark, will also leave an influential impression upon the photographic portraiture arts as an educational document of lasting review, study, and research. In addition to supporting the arts, all contributions are tax deductible. We thank you for considering a gift to this rare publication and look forward to your support.